afternoon on Saturday the 30th of September. We've just finished putting the finishing touches to the St. Luke's premises prior to the homecoming service there tomorrow morning. And our opening prayer. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise, now and forever. Amen. Today's readings are the second book of Chronicles, chapter 7, verses 11 to 16, and Psalm 24. Today, we find ourselves again working around the historical biblical timeline. Of late, we've heard quite a lot about the completion of the Jerusalem temple. But the temple which is being spoken about by myself in the past few days, linking to Ezra, Zechariah and Haggai, is not the one which we hear about in our reading today, which has been completed and then dedicated by Solomon. The temple, which is known as Solomon's Temple, was destroyed in the conquest of Jerusalem prior to the exiles. And when the prophets and Ezra and Nehemiah are speaking about a rebuilding, it's a replacement for that Solomon's Temple. Today, we learn a little bit about the importance of the temple building, which is why, later on, it is so important that it should be rebuilt. The temple building is a special place where God, the King of Glory, comes in, as the psalmist sings. We learn that people go to the temple to call on God's name, to humble themselves before God, and to seek God's face. In other words, to find out what he wants. Importantly, God's eyes and hearts are always there with those who are worshipping him. This was God's purpose when he wanted the temple built in the first place. And yet it is destroyed by a foreign power because the people didn't use it or seek God in the way that they were meant to. At this time of the year, many churches hold their dedication festivals. Here at St. Aidan's and St. Luke's, we tend to focus a little bit more on the patronal festivals. That is those days where we think about the life and ministry of the person who the building is named after. However, dedication festivals are important because they remind us that the building is where it is for a reason. And that is something which patronal festivals don't necessarily do, because the saint that they are often named after actually has nothing to do with the place where the church building is. However, God wants our church buildings to be thriving places where he is honored. God is only truly honored when our relationships with him are maintained in the right manner. Tomorrow, as I've already alluded to, sees the homecoming of worship back into the St. Luke's Church premises. Part of this homecoming is about rededicating and serving you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who reigns with you and the Holy Spirit. Amen. For our prayer points today, we give praise and thanks to God that the St. Luke's Church building is now ready to reopen for the worship of Him. We pray for the team at St. Luke's, including new members who are joining it. And we pray that it is clear how the ministry based at St. Luke's can serve the communities in Bangtok and Galapagos. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And just a reminder about our service timings tomorrow, here at St. Aidan's. For this Sunday only, there is only a 9:30 service. There is no 11 o'clock service at St. Aidan's. And that is because at St. Luke's at 11 o'clock, we are having a joint benefice service to celebrate the homecoming back into the church building. And of course everyone is welcome to join us in that service of thanks and praise. And our blessing to Jesus the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honour, glory and power forever and ever. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son and Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you today